What's going on, guys? This is Tony. Man, things have been nuts in my lawn care business. Been very nuts. This is me doing some planting here. Planted about like 50 different plants for this lady, like literally somewhere in there, like maybe 40 something. But anyway, it's a regular client, which is like the only reason why I did it. Like, I wouldn't do it if like a normal, just some random person was calling me. But anyway, so I did it for this lady, and you know, charge her some, nothing outrageous or anything. You know, so it's going pretty good. The ground, when I did this last week, wasn't too bad, as you can see, chopping out some roots and stuff, but the ground, not too hard. This is kind of under these trees, and so I was trying to figure out which way does she like the tree to be facing right there. So anyway, so what I do is you kind of squish the bucket. You see me doing that? And if you kind of do that, sometimes you kind of need to do it twice. Only did it like once right there, you know, like do it once and then turn the plant, do it again. That way it easily slides out of the bucket and you won't ruin the stalk, you know, like if you just yank it out. And then what I was doing right there is like interrupting the roots, because the roots, they grow, like when the plant is sitting at the nursery, the roots, they just grow in a circle, like inside the pot, you know, so the roots are like the shape of the pot. So you like rip them up a little bit with your hand. So like interrupts them so they can grow, you know, all the other directions and stuff like that. And, so that's what I was doing. And, so yeah, no big deal. Got that one done. But like I said, done like 40 of them. All right, this here, see, what I usually do is hold the shovel up next to the plant to see how deep I need to do it. These two plants are small. I also planted some bigger trees for her, but you hold the shovel up first so you can kind of see how deep you're going to need the hole. And so I was doing that. And, man, it is outrageous. This plant, this little Japanese maple, they call them here where we live, absolutely insane nuts. This little tree right there, I think the lady, I seen the tag on it, I think she paid $190, you know, plus tax and stuff. It's a $200 tree, which I think is insane. So I was kind of going the extra mile because the plant's so expensive. And like around the hole, I like cut a ring, as you can see, so I can try to help the soil kind of be loose around the outer skirts. My dad told me to do that when I was little, doing plants with him. So then I don't do it on all these little plants, but I did it on this one just because the plant was so expensive. You know, sorry about that. But I was trying to be real careful and just rip it up a little bit, not too much, and put that in. And they've been watering them every day and stuff, so hopefully it does great. But like I said, there ain't no plant on the planet that's worth $200 to me. There ain't no plant or bush, period, that's worth $200. In my opinion. But she bought all these plants randomly, and so I planted for her, and so that's what I was doing. And oh, here's some mowing of my new yard. But anyway, this lady had all these plants just like randomly, and then she would like tell me, she would like, I would like go place it somewhere, and she's like, I think one over there, and then I would do that, and then she would say, move it over about a foot or so. So I'll move it over, and so, man, it took as long to place the plants out, you know, as it did to actually plant the plant. So it was over there at like three or four different times, you know, for hour and a half or so, because she kept buying more plants. You know, she started out like 10 or 15, then she called me and got 10 or 15 more, you know, and that kind of thing. So, but anyway, hopefully she's done buying plants and stuff for now. This is my new yard that I showed y'all a couple videos back. I just got it, you know, trim all these bushes up here. The weeds were out of control in all these beds. I got it kind of under control pretty good. Did new pine straw here. Got things cleaned up out in the back. There's a big old pine island you can't see. But anyway, it's doing some mowing here. And this was recorded before it started this. We have a full week of rain right now as I'm editing this video. And that video's will come soon, you know, like a rain vlog kind of thing. But this was before it was rainy, so we're in like a dry spot as of this video. But then right now it's raining every single day. But look at that. Not too bad, not too bad. Even though the yard was dry, they don't have irrigation here or anything. But, yeah, this, the mower did good. Can't remember right now what mower I was using on that yard. Don't know why. Either my Skag or my Snapper, I'm not sure. This is a different bush than the last video. It's just a random one in front of the church. I just want to throw it in here real quick. There's several of these all around the church.
All right, boys, as you can see, we about to get busy. 150 bale longleaf, and it all fits in. It all fit in my enclosed trailer, my 6x12. So that's a cool thing about an enclosed trailer. You can cram that sucker to the roof. So I'll show you after.
All right, boys, let's do a quick walk around on my straw job. You see, it's a big area. It's all over there, all the way curved around, and put some along the street where the grass doesn't grow. Put it here, you see right here, they're gonna pave this, make a parking area. It's a brand new yard that I got, so, you know, it needed some work. You see the grass is still bad. We've been in a real dry spell, but we're supposed to get trim all these bushes, big bushes. Do this. We're supposed to get 3 inches of rain next week, you know, throughout the whole week. So I guess I'm gonna be a soggy butt, you know, all during the week. So I'll have to try to get some video of that, hopefully. You see, punch all this. It was 150 bales, and it looks pretty good, but it's not as good as the straw's just not as good as it. Some of the jobs I've done, in March and stuff like that. And, what I'll do in the future, see, it came over there, all over here. Didn't even have enough to go around those AC units. You see, I could have went over there farther. But I got 150 bales of long leaf pine straw. But still not enough. You see, the property line goes straight up through here. We could came more, but it is a lot of square feet that I pine straw. But like I said, I think the straw falls maybe January, December, January, February, so I think that's when the straw looks the best, and I think you get more per bale. I don't know why, just when I do pine straw, I put the strings put through this arm and then this one, so it is on your back and around both arms. I could barely get, my shoulders are almost too wide because the bales are just light and getting shrunk. Because I know in the winter, you know, earlier in the season, those things, ropes are sagging because the bales are so big. So, but, you know, closer to summer, the better the yard looks as far as the pollen's done and those kind of things. So, I don't know. I guess it's about the same. But I'm going to, next year, I hope to, after April 1st, not do any pine straw. I have all that done by the time April 1st comes. That's my plan. So, all right, here's my gas cans. I went fueled up today. I put the blower there because it slides all around. This is the last thing. This is Saturday. It's probably 2 o'clock. Might even be later than that. Oh, another thing, my watch broke on this yard, or on this pine straw job, so I don't even know what time it is, but... yeah, boys, Saturday, sometime in the afternoon, and I'm finally done for the week. Now, haven't done any of my, haven't done any of my maintenance yet or anything like that. You know, mowers, sharpened blades and stuff, but I'm gonna have to go to the big town and do some shopping for Mother's Day and stuff, so. Quit for now. I have to catch up on that stuff later. So, thank you for watching my videos. I'm super sweat, dirt. Been a long week. I've never done as many yards as I've done this week, and I did this pine straw job too. So, it's been rough, but I made it through it. Next week is all rain, which is not good because I'm gonna be wet. But I don't have any pine straw jobs or anything, I think. So, all right then. Let's keep on mowing together. Let's do it.